Hello again. Now we will turn to the question of how electricity markets work and why they are expected to minimize the cost of electricity supply. This little bit of theory is essential for understanding the challenges of integrating renewable energy. We will focus on organized power exchanges because they facilitate a large share of short-term electricity trade. There are many power exchanges in Europe, which together ensure that electricity can always be traded easily and on short notice. As trade in electricity necessarily takes place before the moment of consumption, the traded volumes do not match consumption precisely. The resulting difference is small, however, and the system operator takes care of it. This is an example of the supply and demand functions in the day-ahead market of the Amsterdam Power Exchange. Because some bids are really high, the area around the intersection of supply and demand is not very visible in this graph. So let's zoom in. Here you see the same functions around the area where they intersect. The red line indicates the supply bids, and the blue line the demand bids. The market clearing price is determined by the intersection of the supply and demand functions. In this case, it is €35.29. All generation bids that are lower than the market clearing price are accepted. All accepted bids receive the same price. This is called a marginal bid auction. In this market design, some plants receive a price higher than their bids. This provides an incentive to bid low. In theory, power plants are bid in at the very lowest price at which their owner is willing to operate them. This method of market clearing ensures that demand is met at the lowest possible cost. On the demand side, all bids above the market clearing price are accepted. All of them pay the market clearing price. Here the situation is mirrored. If you bid high, you can be sure that your bid is accepted, while you pay the same market price as everyone. The demand bids to the right of the intersection and below the market clearing price are not accepted. Their willingness to pay is lower than the market price. Let's take a closer look at the question of how generators bid in a market like this, in which all generators receive the same price. Imagine you're the owner of a natural gas-fired power plant. How would you decide when to run it and at which price? Your power plant has two types of costs. The fixed costs are the costs you have to pay independent of how much your plant is producing. Examples of fixed costs are the capital cost, fixed operating maintenance costs, and wages. The other type of costs are the variable costs. The variable costs of a plant are the costs that do depend on its output. The most relevant are the costs of the fuel, the natural gas, and the costs of the CO2 emissions, if applicable. The variable costs are therefore calculated per unit of output. So which costs do you consider when you decide whether to operate the plant? Only your variable costs. Why? Because when the price is higher than your variable costs, you have a positive net cash flow. Then you earn more from selling electricity than you spend on running your plant. Whether your fixed costs are high or low is not relevant for the decision whether to run your plant. When you have a positive cash flow, this will help to pay off these fixed costs. Whether this is enough to cover them totally in the long run does not matter now. Any positive cash flow from operating your plant is better than none, given that you need to make your fixed cost payments anyway. A strongly related concept is marginal cost. This is the cost of producing an additional unit of output. So in our case, the marginal cost of a power plant is the cost of producing an additional megawatt hour of electricity. Sometimes the variable cost and marginal cost terms are used interchangeably because for fossil fuel plants, they're approximately the same within the normal operating range of a plant. The system marginal cost is another important concept. This is the cost of producing one more unit of electricity by the whole market. This is equal to the variable cost of the most expensive plant that is needed to meet demand. The variable cost of the marginal plant. So let's look at an example. You know now that you have certain fixed costs plus a certain amount of variable costs per unit of electricity that your plant produces. Let's say your variable costs are €20 per megawatt hour. Imagine now that you could get €15 per megawatt hour in the market. Would you run your plant? No. The market price, your income, is less than your variable costs, your operating expenses. So per unit of electricity that you sell, you earn 15 euros and you spend 20 euros on fuel. In this case, you would make an operating loss of 5 euros on every megawatt hour you produce. So it's better not to run your plant at this time. What if the market price were 25 euros? Exactly. Now you would run your plant because your income is higher than your operating expenses. You would make a profit of 5 euros on every megawatt hour you produce and sell. These 5 euros are called inframarginal rent. While the electricity price varies constantly, every time the price is higher than your variable costs, it's worth to run your plant. Whatever your fixed payments are, these operating profits contribute to them. And if you have enough operating profits over the year, you may earn enough to pay your fixed costs and make a net profit. So in a power exchange in which the marginal bid sets the market price for all, the optimal price bid is equal to the variable costs of the plant. It may sound counterintuitive not to take the fixed costs into account. How then do you know that you can recover your fixed costs? Aren't you better off if you bid higher? Let's check. Here we have a small market with three plants. Demand is 1200 megawatt. At this level of demand, the market price is 20 euros per megawatt hour. Why is this the price? Because all three plants are needed to meet demand. The variable cost of plant C is 20 euros per megawatt hour, so this is his bid. If the price were lower, this plant would have no reason to run. Let's look at plant B. This plant currently makes an operating profit of 5 euros per megawatt hour. Now imagine that plant B raises its bid by 7 euros per megawatt hour in an attempt to include its fixed costs in the price. Its price bid is now the highest in the market, so the plant moves to the right in the merit order. Market demand can now be met by plants A and C alone, so our plant B, now being the most expensive one, ends up not selling anything at all. Plant B loses the 5 euros per megawatt hour of operating profit that he was making before. The fact that plant C is now running on higher capacity also means that the total fuel costs have increased. The electricity is no longer generated in the most cost-efficient manner. Assuming efficient bidding, let's have a closer look at how fixed costs are recovered in marginal bid auctions. This graph shows a market in which the price varies over the course of a week. For the sake of simplicity, we show only one price per day here. Assume that the variable costs, shown by the gray dotted line, stay the same throughout the week because the fuel price does not change so quickly. As we saw, you only want to run your plant when the market price is equal to or higher than the variable costs. On 5 days, you would therefore operate your plant. On 2 days, your plant would not run. These operating profits contribute to covering the fixed costs. Optimally, all these profits added up over the entire time period, the area between the variable cost line and under the graph, should cover the fixed costs completely. We can also look at this in a slightly different way. This is a price duration curve with all the market price sorted from the highest to the lowest. The variable costs of our plant, we assume they are constant over the year, are 40 euros per megawatt hour. As the plant only runs when the market price is higher than its variable costs, it runs close to 90% of the time. During these hours, it spends 40 euros per megawatt hour on variable costs. The difference between the price and this cost is its operating profit. So the sum of all the operating profits pay off the fixed costs. There is, however, no certainty that you will cover your fixed costs. There is investment risk. If generators do not recover their costs, they will stop investing. Over time, as plants get older and are taken out of service, this will lead to scarcity. Then the market price goes up and investors recover their costs again. If the price goes higher and profits become very large, this will attract new investment, which will cause the price to go down again. So in theory, the market leads to an equilibrium in which supply meets demand and investors just recover their costs. Let's recapitulate what we've covered. In day-ahead markets, supply and demand are matched every hour. Because everyone receives the same market price, plants have an incentive to bid their capacity at variable costs. Market prices higher than variable costs contribute to covering their fixed costs. This is the case whenever a more expensive plant sets the price. As a result, at each hour, the generators receive with the lowest variable costs run, and therefore demand is met at the lowest cost possible. Marginal bid auctions are not the only way to match supply and demand. Bilateral markets are another common way in which electricity is traded. Want to find out more? Watch the next videos.